So as per the poll, you guys wanted me to make a review of OnePlus Nord as a gaming smartphone. So here it is. And a video on Gcam versus Stock will come really soon. So stay tuned. But before we get into that, let's revise the specs of this OnePlus Nord. So it has a 7nm Snapdragon 765G processor, clocked at 2.34 GHz, with 8GB of RAM and 128GB of storage. And it has Adreno 620 graphics processing unit, that is GPU. Now let's focus on the gaming part. So I will play some of the most popular titles on a stretch, namely PUBG, I mean Call of Duty, but I'll share some interesting details about PUBG though, Free Fire, because why not, PES, Asphalt 9, Altos Odyssey, and some casual games like Subway Surfers and Temple Run to finish this test off. So first of all, I'll charge my device to 100% to check the battery drain as well. Also guys, I'll be doing this test using my mobile data and Wi-Fi, because a lot of you reported issues on gaming with mobile data. So let me start with the good and bad news both. So the good news is that you can play PUBG in smooth and extreme settings on this OnePlus Nord after the latest 1.0 update, and it does perform really well after this. And the bad news is that you cannot download it officially. So I hope a newer version for India will come really soon, and for those of you who are not located in India can enjoy this new version. And let me tell you, the graphics are great and it looks and feels a lot better than before with this update. So go ahead and check it out and have a good time. For users in India, let's move on to Call of Duty. So the game can run on maximum graphics settings, that is very high, so I've kept it on that only. And you can see that the game is running just fine and there are no dropped frames, unlike what we had with PUBG. The game in general is more optimized and thus we get better performance with this one. So I'll play a game or two on the maximum graphics settings and then let's check the battery temperature and percentage drop. So guys, after a game almost, the device feels alright as of now and I don't feel any heat ups or frame drops, which is really good. So I'll play it for like 30 minutes and then let's look into the stats. And after 30 minutes of gaming, there are no issues as such. And in all this time, I faced no hiccups, the game ran just fine and the device did render the shadows and all the details really well. So no dropped frames or any lag, and the battery temperature now is around 41 degrees, which isn't that much. So the battery percentage remaining is 83%, down from 94%. So around 30 minutes of Call of Duty consumed around 11% of battery. Now let's move on to the next game, Free Fire. So the main comment I got from you guys was regarding disconnection issues while playing the game on mobile data. So let's see if that is the case with my device as well. So starting the game with default settings, and since this one is not so graphic intensive, I see no issues at all in rendering. The game is running smoothly on this device and as usual, no dropped frames or issues, and I'll play a couple of games and get back to you with the results. By the way, if you're liking this video, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already to stay notified about the latest videos from this channel. Now I'll change the graphic settings to maximum possible, so let's play a couple of games on that. So around 20 minutes of Free Fire consumed around 10% of battery, and the battery temperature now is around 41.5 degrees, so almost 42 after playing Free Fire on maximum settings. So I do feel some heat up on topmost portion of the device, but it isn't that much. About the mobile data dropping issue, well, I faced it occasionally for a few seconds, but after that the game ran just fine for me. It did not bother me much and I could play the game easily on mobile data. But let's hope that issue will be fixed soon. Let's move on to Asphalt 9, and this one too is quite less intensive in graphics. So let's start the game, and due to 8GB of RAM in this variant, you can see everything is just buttery smooth, without any glitches so far. The game feels perfectly fine and there are no issues in rendering and almost no frame drops. So I'll play the game for next 15 minutes or so and then let's check out the battery percentage and temperature. Moving on to the next game in line, PES. So some of you requested me in past to cover this one as well, so here it is. And I have set the game to very high graphics option so you guys can have an idea on how it will run on OnePlus Nord. And as you can see, the game is quite optimized and there are no issues in running it on maximum graphics settings. and just like other games, I'll play it for 15 minutes and then share my experience with you guys. So the gameplay was nice and smooth, and as expected, the device did not heat up that much, and it could handle everything quite easily. So that is good, and the battery temperature now is around 41 degrees. Coming to the last few casual games, Temple Run and Subway Surfers. Well, I don't have any doubts that the device will handle these games very well, of course. And you can play both of these games for hours on a stretch, so no complaints there too. To sum up, I would like to say that this OnePlus Nord is a good smartphone for gaming, as it can not only support most of the intensive games, but can even play some good titles in maximum graphic settings, at least after the updates. But do note, if the battery percentage is less than 20, the device starts to show signs of slowdown, and hence drop frames. But overall, there weren't much issues apart from Free Fire disconnection issue on mobile data. So let's hope OnePlus acknowledges those issues and fix them for us really soon. Rest, it was all fine for me, but if you faced any other issues, do let me know in the comment section down below. So do like this video if it helps you out, and lastly subscribe to stay next one.